The interesting aspect is help reduce the number of services we need. Is that at all possible? Is that a realistic goal?
Oh, absolutely. If you look at the state of Florida and if you look at Palm Beach County, our demand for system is tremendously out of proportion with the rest of the nation. And what we've been able to do in just a few short months is actually reduce the number of children who are coming into foster care by over 30%. And we're doing that by serving children with their families and by doing upfront diversion work rather than removing children. But having said that, one of the things that I think your viewers need to understand about child welfare in Palm Beach County is that every hour of every day, 365 days a year, there is a call to the abuse hotline that comes to Palm Beach County. Relentlessly, every hour of every day. In the past, probably 13 months, every day, two children were being removed from their families every day in Palm Beach County. I don't think that most people in this community, just as most people in many communities who are not involved in the business, understand the magnitude of the issue that we're dealing with.
And those numbers are staggering. There's where, to me, the first step is almost overwhelming. People watching, how can I help? I mean, we're talking about infants, we're going to get to that in a moment. We're talking about teenagers. We're talking about every race, color, and creed. It's
Absolutely. Not
a specific minority problem. It's not a specific this neighborhood problem. We should make that clear.
That's clear. And it transcends all socioeconomic groups, all ages of children. We get children from, you know, newborns out of the hospital to children who are young adults, basically, who are 17 and a half years old. In this business, you never know what tomorrow's going to bring. You never know what the next call's going to be. You never know where the next family in crisis is going to come from.
And with that, you know, I read the numbers of foster families have actually diminished. Do you think that's because people are kind of frightened of these kids?
I don't know. I wouldn't say that people are frightened of these kids. I just don't think that we do a very good job of educating families about who are these children and what is the need and what can they do. And you're going to hear from some great agencies today who provide tremendous support to the foster families that are in their systems of care. And without them, we couldn't do this work.
And I have to back that up. I mean, we've spent months with these people literally in the field, and I am overwhelmed with the amount of work they can pull out in the number of hours that are in a day. Within your own organization, bright people, committed people. That's one thing I've learned. If you're in this business, you better be committed, because it can be a rather depressing theme to the day some days. But at the same time, there's happy endings, because families like the ones we're speaking to and the ones we want to call tonight are coming forward, and they're finding it so rewarding when they do become a foster or adoptive family. And I'm not just saying that. I really have watched these families and listened to their stories. And once you get through the 10 weeks, I think we're going to talk about that in a minute, you're just so happy when these kids come into your home.
Absolutely. And it's a, you know, and from the child's perspective, it's a rather frightening experience from their perspective. So to have a loving, caring, warm set of parents who are there accepting that child, supporting that child, bringing love and attention and making sure the child understands that, you know, we know your parents love you. We know they do. Unfortunately, right now, that you can't be with them, and we're going to help you, and we're going to keep you safe, and for the next whatever bit of time, you're going to be part of our family. Is the connection that we need to make between families and kids.
And that's the exact connection that we want you to make right now by calling the number on your screen. I'm telling you, it's simple. Some of the information may be a little bit overwhelming when you first hear it, but I promise you, they make it so simple. They have so much out there to support you. One of the things I found surprising, I did not know this prior to researching this theme, is when these kids turn 18, basically the system is no longer theirs. Because of state laws, they must leave foster care, stop getting any kind of aid. obviously, when you're 18 years old, especially in Palm Beach County, most of us would not be able to stand on our own 2 feet with the cost of living and everything else facing us. You're going to meet an agency that is doing something to change that.
People don't realize that there's a lot of supports. You know, if you decide that you want to, you know, give it a try, it's not a lifetime commitment.
At 6 years old, Patrice Wilfork told her kindergarten teacher that her mom was using drugs and hurting her and her little sister, and that she was scared to go back home.
A couple days later, my mom actually beat me so bad that my aunt had called the police. She got arrested and she was in jail for 6 months. And my sister was taking care of us in the meantime, but she really wasn't home. She was at work most of the time.
The situation was so bad, child welfare agents took Patrice and her 5-year-old sister away and placed them in foster care. And by the time she was 14, she had lived with 19 different foster families and been in 13 different schools.
It was very frustrating to know that I had to move.
The reality is that we have as a country done these children an injustice.
Charles Binder runs Place of Hope, a privately funded foster neighborhood where children are raised in a traditional family setting with two parents and the promise of stability. Patrice's therapist thought it would be a place she could finally call home.
It was scary at first because I never had an interview for any of the homes that I were in, so.
The teenager has lived with her Place of Hope parents for nearly 4 years now. But when she turns 18 in just a few weeks, the state says she must move out. For Binder, putting kids like Patrice back on the street is unthinkable.
Unfortunately, in America today, your average child is, or youth at 18, is not able to make it on their own. Your average kid in America today isn't financially independent until the average age of 24, 25 years old. So these kids are no different. In fact, in some ways, they're a little bit behind that eight ball because of their backgrounds and having been in multiple foster homes, et cetera. So we have to, you know, take that into consideration.
So Binder and his board raised enough private money to buy and renovate these duplexes. Villages of Hope is more than a spot to send those who are aging out of the system. It's where young adults can get a head start on life.
Kids actually don't pay rent. They pay a program fee, and it's sliding scale based on income and what they're doing with school and so forth, and it's case by case. But that does help to offset some of the costs of bringing in the additional services for the children.
Patrice has already begun getting used to her new independence.
We have no one to tell us to do our chores. We have to do them on our own. And, like, we have to buy our own groceries. And we have to pay our own rent. And basically, we have to maintain jobs and maintain in school.
And there are rules here. Midnight curfews, no parties, and no skipping school.
Sometimes it's very overwhelming.
Hope is what fuels this village. Binder has plans to expand, knowing more than 100 kids in Palm Beach County will turn 18 and be kicked out of foster care within the next year.
We just have to be there with that toolbox of life and just to be able to say, here's the tools. We're going to give you everything. This community, this village has said, we have everything for you, whether we have people that will pay for college where the state won't, we have people that will pay for transportation assistance where the state won't, but you have to prove that you're going to try your best to make something out of your life.
It makes me feel proud to know that I'm doing what I desire to do. And I don't have to look down on myself and say I can't do it.
Binder believes this sense of pride will help these young adults succeed and surpass their often unbelievable childhoods. And that is just one step towards righting an unforgivable wrong.